think it's probably already reflected in the record, but I want to make sure the record reflected that Mr. Knox actually brought over a whiteboard and furniture and drew some diagrams, which eliminate the issue of whether or not any diagrams he prepared prior to trial were admitted, because he was allowed to draw the exact same diagrams before the jury. That was the only thing I wanted to add. Just, you know, because it was a demonstration of sorts, I want to make sure the record is clear that that was done during the trial.
We would clearly disagree that the demonstrative diagrams that Mr. Knox was allowed to draw and draw during the course of the trial would have been as effective as the presentation that he created. But other than that, we would rely on our prior argument.
Well, what's referenced there is the animated drawings, what I call drawings, and video, if you will, which is almost like looking at the drawings in fast succession, maybe in the video. And I have reasons that I stated on the reference to why I did not think that that was appropriate for the jury's consideration. I've reviewed the motion, the grounds that were raised there, and I will rely on the rulings that I made previously during the course of the trial, and the motion for a new trial is denied. We're now ready to proceed to sentencing. First, we have pre-sentence report, actually two. Mr. Strobel is here as attorney for Mrs. Dunn during the first trial back in February. And we had a pre-sentence investigation report prepared back then. And then after Mr. Dunn's being found guilty by a jury just recently, we had that pre-sentence investigation report updated. So, Mr. Stroh, if you have a chance to review both the original and the amended pre-sentence investigation report.
Yes, Your Honor.
And Ms. Kennedy, have you also had a chance to review that?
I have, Your Honor, and I have reviewed the amended pre-sentence investigation report with Mr. Dunn as well.
Okay. Mr. Stroh, any exceptions or objections? I guess we really rely on the amended because it's updated. Any exceptions or objections from your point of view?
None.
Ms. Henry, any exceptions or objections on behalf of Mr. Dunn or your
phone? Your Honor, there's just three minor things. It's not really a correction as such, but just maybe some things for the record on page one. I would just like to note that in terms of Mr. Dunn's credit, it would be 692 days as of today, as opposed to the date that's listed in the pre-sentence investigation report. As I said, it wasn't an error, so I'd like to reflect the updated number as of today's day. The other thing, Your Honor, as of page 5 of the pre-sentence investigation report, the only prior...
So you're actually referring to the amended?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Page 5 of the amended pre-sentence investigation, I apologize, Your Honor. The only prior that Mr. Dunn had of a DUI and driving charge in 1988. And while this reflects a BOP warrant was issued on that, we wanted to note for the record that that was literally a clerical error by the clerk of the court there, that the paperwork indicating his compliance with probation had not been put into the system. So it was not a situation in which he had violated any of the conditions of his probation, and we just wanted to make that for the record. The only other thing, Your Honor, is on page 11, I just wanted to note that I had indicated to the probation office that I would reserve comment for today prior to the creation of this document. That would be all.
From the state, any exceptions or objections to either the original or the amended pre-sentence investigation?
Judge, on the amended, just a couple of things. I want to clear up on page 1, the designation of the division. I thought we had agreed on division D.
No. Actually, oddly enough, in a twist of fate, this case actually began in division I with Judge Bass. It then, after recusal, went to Division D, and then state would have it, after being appointed to the circuit court bench, I am now in Division I, which is where the case originated, oddly enough. So I had it transferred back to Division I, which is where it all started.
Very good.
So Division I is the proper division designation.
Thank you for the clarification. Judge, on page two, is again a hypothetical issue. The last paragraph reads that the trial commenced on the 29th, I believe it was the 22nd of September.
Correct. All right, I'll have to
that's all
probation right. Make that correction. All right. Before we begin, I want to remind immediately, well, not remind, but I think they already know that we actually have some jurors here today that were jurors in the most recent trial, and the my order regarding confidentiality still remains in full force and effect, so please do not attempt to photograph and approach them or videotape them in any way. That brings us then to Mr. Strolla and or Ms. Anania. Well, first, Mr. Strolla, you prepared and filed, I believe, a sentencing memorandum, which I have considered, and attached were a variety of letters that I have read and considered, which is all part of the court file. So, for the record, I just want to use that. And then we proceed to any other presentations that have Mr. Dunn, either through Mr. Strolla or Ms. Hamlin.
Your Honor, at this time, Mr. Dunn's parents are present, and a number of family and friends scattered around the states as well as throughout the state of Florida who care at Lovington and support him and would have been present today. However, this has been a difficult situation for them, as it's been for everyone. And because they understand the sentencing structure currently in place in Florida and the requirements of Your Honor based on that sentencing structure, they have elected not to put themselves through an emotional display of making a statement to the court because of the fantasy and futility of those statements and the emotional difficulty that it would impose upon them. So at this time, the only other thing that we would present would be a written statement from Mr. Dunn.
All right. We're here this morning for sentencing in the case of the state of Florida versus Michael Dunn. Drawings in fast succession, maybe in the video. And I reasons that I stated on the record as to why I did not think that that was appropriate for jury's consideration. I reviewed the motion, the grounds that were raised there, and I will rely on the rulings that I made previously during the course of the trial. But the motion for a new trial is denied. So we're now ready to proceed to sentencing. First, we have pre-sentence report, actually two. Mr. Strobel is here as attorney for Mr. Dunn during the first trial back in February. And we had a pre-sentence investigation report prepared back then. And then after Mr. Dunn's being found guilty by a jury just recently, we had that pre-sentence investigation report updated. So, Mr. Strobel, if you have a chance to review both the original and the amended pre-sentence investigation report.
Yes, sir. I.
And Ms. Candidia, have you also had a chance to review that?
I have, Your Honor, and I have reviewed the amended pre-sentence investigation report with Mr. Dunn as well.
Okay. Mr. Strobel, any exceptions or objections? I guess we really rely on the amended because it's okay. Any exceptions or objections from your point?
None.
Ms. Henry, any exceptions or objections on behalf of Mr. Dunn?
Your Honor, there's just three minor things. It's not really a correction as such, but just maybe some things for the record on page one. I would just like to note that in terms of Mr. Dunn's credit, it would be 692 days as of today, as opposed to the date for today prior to the creation of this document. That would be all.
From the state, any exceptions or objections to either the original or the amended pre-sentence investigation?
Judge, on the amended, just a couple of things. I want to clarify on page one, the designation of the division. I thought we had agreed on division D.
No. Actually, oddly enough, in a twist of fate, this case actually began in division I with Judge Bass. It then, after recusal, went to Division D, and then after that judge got out of the case, it technically stayed in Division D because I was county court judge at the time, just sitting as a circuit judge on the first trial. But as fate would have it, after being appointed to the circuit court bench, I am now in Division I, which is where the case originated, oddly enough. So I had it transferred back to Division I, which is where it all started.
Very good.
So Division I is the proper division designation.
Thank you for the clarification.
That's listed in the pre-sentence investigation report. As I said, it wasn't an error, but to reflect the updated number as of today's day. The other thing, Your Honor, as of page 5 of the pre-sentence investigation report, the only prior...
So you're actually referring to the amended.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Page 5 of the amended sentence of the HIV father's term. The only prior that Mr. Dunn had is a DUI and driving charge in 1988. And while this reflects that a BOP warrant was issued on that, we wanted to note for the record that that was literally a clerical error by the clerk of the court there, that the paperwork indicating his compliance with probation had not been put into the system. So it was not a situation in which he had violated any of the conditions of his probation. And we just wanted to make that for the record. The only other thing, Your Honor, is on page 11, I just wanted to note that I had indicated to the probation office that I would reserve comment.